Hey guys, it is Danny, and I'm here with updates on Eta. Actually, some major updates, and the hurricane is now expected to make landfall as a deadly Category 4 monster with packing winds of up to 140 miles per hour, guys. And so, before I go into all the necessary details on Eta, please do subscribe if you haven't, and tap the bell so you know every time when I post a new video, because I will keep you guys updated on tropical activity right throughout the season. And you can also follow me on Instagram. My weather account is WeatherGirlDanny, and my personal account is DannyHenryOfficial. Okay, guys, so let us go back to the satellite view of Eta right now and see. Let's talk about how it's looking. So we're starting to see that defined eye. It was not very clear this morning, so this storm is rapidly intensifying, guys, and so it's starting to get more compact, and some of the outer rain bands have already started affecting portions of Central America. So Nicaragua and Honduras have already started feeling the impacts from this, and it will only get worse. And so now here we have the National Hurricane Center's cone forecast. And at this time, Eta has sustained winds of 110 miles per hour. So remember, guys, it's this morning, just several hours ago, it became a hurricane, and it's just on the verge of being a Cat 3. And so we have a hurricane warning in place for most of the northeastern portion of Nicaragua. We have a tropical storm watch, hurricane watch, and tropical storm warning in place for the northern and eastern portion of Honduras. And so the storm is expected to maybe make landfall tomorrow morning, and so it is likely that this is going to be bringing some life-threatening conditions. So persons that reside in the areas, especially near to the coastline, are urged to take necessary precautions. So if you live along the coastline, it's best to get out, because the surge is going to be very, very significant, and the flooding is going to be there. Those strong winds that will likely cause power outages and might destroy some structures. So please, guys, if you're in those areas, Honduras and Nicaragua, please take the necessary precautions and stay safe. And then afterwards, it will be moving more inland, and it will be weakening rapidly. So despite its weakening, it is still going to be a rainfall threat, especially to Honduras, and then it might re-emerge back into the northwestern Caribbean. And so here we have Ramaz agreeing that it's going to be moving into the northwestern Caribbean and possibly making landfall in Cuba. It's probably going to be re-strengthened at that time as well. So we really have to wait and see what the eventual outcome of this will be. But if you're in Cuba, you want to be on alert, because maybe by early next week, you could be facing landfall. And so, guys, let's look at our models, what two of our models, the Euro and the GFS, are expecting at the time of landfall. So here we have the GFS model, and this is by Tuesday, November 3rd. So again, tomorrow. And so we have the isobars, which are the black lines, just so compact. This is showing a very strong, a very significant tropical cyclone. And going on to what the Euromal is showing now, basically the same thing, guys. So this is going to be very significant, but take a look at that. So this is actually by Wednesday, so the storm is also going to be decreasing in its acceleration as it approaches land. So it's going to be around for quite some time, guys. And so, guys, that is really it for this update. And if you found this video to be pretty informative, please give a thumbs up. And you can also share your thoughts with me in the comments or ask a question. I'll try to respond as best and as soon as I can. And just remember to always be weather wise, and I'll keep giving all your necessary updates on the tropics as time goes by.